Okay, nou hallo Nederland. Ik doe dit begin even in het Nederlands, maar het interview gaat in het Engels. Ik ben hier met Manish. Manish is uit Indië en hij is al vaker geweest hier in Moskou. En hij is nu in de Donbass geweest, dus ik ga hem nu even vragen en dan gaan we verder in het Engels. Hello Manish.
Hi, thank you so much.
Nice that you are back in Moscow again. We know each other already since Kherson. And you were in Donbass. Can you tell me, or first maybe introduce yourself to the viewers in the Netherlands?
Okay. Hi guys, this is Manish Jha. I'm a journalist from India. I represent TV9, which is the largest news network in India. And you will be surprised to know that we have 700 million of viewership. So I think it's double of Europe's population. So you can understand about my TV network. And in the last 1 year, I have spent around 5 months in Russia. I have visited many parts, Donbass and Crimea and some other parts. And obviously, I have visited few front lines, and I have just come back from front line to Moscow and meeting Sonia. I really respect her, and she is so kind, and every time I learn something from her. So thank you so much, Sonia, for having me.
Thanks for your kind words, Manish. And so it was your first time in the Donbass, or second time? What was your experience this time?
Well, it's a third time, right?
The
first
time
I was visiting with, the first time I met with you, and she was so, you were so helpful that you fed me actually. You know, I was so hungry and you gave me some food, and it was first time. And then the second time I spent there quite long, like it was around 1 month or 2 months. So this was my third time, and each and every time when I visit Donbass, it is a great learning experience for me, and I can say that it's a learning experience for life, you know, because we all know that what is going on in Donbass, and that's why.
And what is your experience this time? Is it, did it became worse? I mean, the fighting or the situation than when you visited last time? Or do you think you saw some improvement already? Or what is your overall experience?
Well, this time when I was visiting all the areas, like I was visiting Donetsk, I was in Avdiivka, I was in Luhansk, then I visited a Kharkiv region. So I was in Avdiivka front line, I was in Svatovo front line, it is in Kharkiv. And the first I'll tell you about Donetsk and surrounding the place. So if we call about the DPR, so I think if I'm not wrong, then more than 90% is completely under control of Russian authority, Russian forces. And things are changing, like there are few development works also. I find some new roads, and obviously if we compare with our first visit when we visited in May, June, then I was there in the month of September, October. So now in my third visit, what I think that now the DPR people, the Donbass people, start themselves introducing like that, yes, they are Russian, they are Russian citizens, and they now they are acting like that they are the Russian citizens.
They are Russian now, so you felt the difference with last time when they still, you know, felt maybe they were part of Ukraine, because Donbass was then part of Ukraine still. And of course, we I went to in September, I went as an international observer to the referendum. And did people speak about this still, that they are very happy to have joined Russia?
You rightly said, you know, the first time when we visited, that time they were in the dilemma that what is going on, what will happen, we they don't know. The second time that you were their observer in the referendum. But in third time when I visited there, so what happening that now they are thinking that this is their future, like they are Russian citizens. So now the things they're trying to move on.
Okay.
That means that now they are expecting that the Moscow will start their development work as soon as possible. So
yes,
they will get some kind of relief because for the last 8 years, 9 years, what was going on there, so lots of work to be done.
Yeah.
And what I found between them, there was a hope.
Okay.
You know, the hope and then sense of security that yes, now we are the part of the Russian Federation and the Moscow will save us. So now they are, you know, like feeling like somehow secure, safe, secure.
Better and, than them. Yeah. Okay. And did you see rebuilding the city where you were or the villages? Did you see that the people themselves or help with the Russian rebuilding already? Started to rebuild?
Well, if I would like to start with Mariupol, yes, of course, everyone knows that the Russians are starting rebuilding in Mariupol.
Okay.
First time when I visited there, more than 3,000 flats was rebuilt.
Okay.
I can say that it was newly constructed.
Yeah.
I have done many reports from even the inside of the house. And that was really good.
Yeah.
Really good in that sense that I can compare with in my hometown, like Delhi or Mumbai, and I can say that the flat was really good.
Okay.
And the second thing which I would like to discuss is that yes, you know, there are so many development work which is going on. There are lots of changes. Like now, if you go to Donbass area, so there are less hurdle. Like in the border and then thereafter.
Okay.
So
bureaucracy.
Yeah, it was very smooth bureaucracy.
Okay.
Because now,
that's great.
Yeah. So like if you have a Russian passport visa, it's okay for them.
Okay.
And now they don't ask you some kind of separate paper.
Okay.
Like the Russian accreditation card, journalist card was sufficient for me to go any place. They never asked me that, no, where is your local accreditation, which was happening earlier.
Yes,
so
I know.
That,
yeah.
You know, when my belief is, once bureaucracy changed, it means everything is okay. And bureaucracy was behaving there like they are the part of the Russian Federation.
Very good. And to conclude, what you would like to say to the people in Europe? I mean, I'm from the Netherlands, but okay, many people in other countries from Europe are watching because they are still a little bit brainwashed in Europe about the situation in the Donbass. What can you tell them about Moscow? What is your feeling that Europe should change this, or the people should start looking, watching different kind of news?
Well, since you are from Netherlands, I am from India, and everyone knows that what is India's position is. We are very neutral. And trust me, as a journalist, I was very much objective. No one paid me.
No.
My company paid me. So I am here with funding of my company, not with anyone else.
Yeah.
And so my objective was that I should be neutral and I should be truthful that what is really happening there. Mm-hmm. And what I found, the first thing, which is really same for everyone, that once anyone died in Kyiv or Kharkiv or Lviv, the whole world knows it. You know, that the Russian did that. But when the people died in Donbass, no one cares.
Yeah.
You know, this is not good. Life is life. If someone is killed in your country, if someone is killed in my country, the same thing with the Donbass people. And the fact is that the last week when I went there, the day I arrived, Donetsk, just before that half an hour ago, the one long-range HIMARS was welcoming me, and because of that attack, 2 civilian, 4 medical staffs were killed, and 10 emergency fire brigade staffs were wounded.
Yeah.
So the thing is that first of all, we have to understand that.
Yeah.
If we believe in democracy, then people has right to decide that who will be their leader and what is their decision, what is their will, and they have spoken with their will. So we can't do anything. Number one, and the second thing is, yes, Ukrainian forces are attacking on them, And if they are attacking on them, and at the same time, they are saying that this is my land. So guys, do you think that they just need land, not people? To keep, technically, the Donbass people are their people. Then why they are attacking? So yeah. This is the main question.
Yeah.
I think that everyone should answer up.
Exactly. And also, I think Europe should understand that in a war, there are always two sides. So, and reporting just one side and say they are the enemy is very wrong for a neutral part actually in Europe saying this. So this is actually the whole point. And you cannot take one side. You have to show two sides.
If we journalists do not take any side.
Exactly.
No one side, no another side.
Yeah.
You know. I am telling you, my correspondent is in Europe, my correspondent is in Ukraine, I am in Russia, and we are trying to see that, okay, what is going on, and this is
nothing
how
more.
We are, and this is how I am reporting from here, this is how, and whenever I find that, okay, this is wrong, I openly say, this is how democracy should function, this is how freedom of press works.
Exactly, how journalists should behave.
And thank God that I am from India, that no one is telling me that you cannot come from there, and
what is going on.
Yeah. But unfortunately, it is not only in Netherlands,
in the
part of the Europe.
Western countries.
So I am telling that, you know, even as an Indian, I was looking for Europe as a great society, as a democracy. But today, are you independent? Are you free? Are you acting on free will? No. Because what is your national interest? The national interest is you see your people, your future, and then decide what is wrong and what is right.
Exactly. Okay, great. Thanks a lot for your interview. And
thank you so much. Thank you so much. And it's nice to meet you again.
Nice to meet you again.
Thank you so much.
We cooperate more. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks.